Hey there, how are you doing? Today I will show you how to play Great Dane by Cosmo Pike. This song was requested by all these people. Thank you so much for all of your comments. Thank you. Yeah, I'm going to do it as usual. Play the song with the chords over here. And afterwards I will also explain to you maybe some more difficult parts of the song and different ways to play it. And the song is just in standard tuning. Nothing weird, no capo or anything like that. So yeah. If you're good with finger picking, I recommend to play the song using your fingers, but you can also use a pick. That's totally fine as well. That's what I like to do, but yeah, you can choose by yourself. Yeah, I think that's really it. I hope everything is clear. Please like and subscribe, check out my Patreon stuff. I hope to see you after I play the song. Thank you. So yeah, that's how to play the song. First of all, this part. This is quite a tricky chord, but you just have to practice it a lot. And then this part, you gotta use your pinky for that. So you do that, and then you slide to the 12th fret. That's one of the first things that might be a bit tricky there. You'll get the hang of it when you practice a lot. There's a lot of pinky stuff going on in this song, so yeah, try to practice with your pinky. So yeah, then the second thing that might be a bit difficult is this F melody, this second melody in the F major, in the F major 7 chord. So what you simply does is gonna play the whole chord, then play the two bottom strings, on the 3rd fret, then you gotta stretch your finger, your index finger, to play the F note here. Then you gotta unstretch it to play the E note on the E string. And then you gotta play the C note on the B string with your index finger. Like that. And then after that, what he basically does, he does again play the whole chord, then the bottom two strings, then the bottom two strings. And to do that, you gotta hammer on your index finger on the C over here. So hammer on and pull off. Like that. And then suddenly he goes to this F minor, which I play like this, but you can also play the F minor like this. But that's a little bit too much, so you can do it like this as well. Then he goes to the G7, and then the other part starts. And then there's also a difficult pinky thing he does. With every A, when he goes down from the A minor 7 to the G minor 7, he does this. And it's not that clear to hear, but he hammers on and pulls off with his pinky the ninth note of every chord. So here it is, the B with the G sharp minor 7. He does it with the A sharp. With the G minor 7, he does it with the A note. Yeah, it's just a matter of practice, and it's okay if you don't do it. When he does it live, he doesn't always do it, but in the studio version, I think it happens the whole time that he does it. And if this finger position is a bit difficult, you can also do it like this. I think I did that also just a few minutes ago, like this. So you play the A minor like this instead of like this, with your thumb on the A, and then you can also do it with your pinky. You can also do it with your ring finger. That might be a bit difficult. And then he does this. And when he does it live, he sometimes does it like this. So instead of this, sometimes does it live like this. He normally plays it here, but sometimes when he's playing it live, he plays the E here. And even makes it an E7 most of the time. To go back to the A minor 7. Yeah, I think that's it what I wanted to tell you. I hope everything was clear. Feel free to suggest a new song, definitely. I hope to see you next time in my video. Thank you so much for watching again.